Keep on loading the bag up.
Of course. For my baby.
Oh, no way. No way. Yeah, just drop everything in there. If you ask why I come to see my parents so often, it's because every time I come, my mom puts me a goodie bag. You're going to need to fill this one up high because tomorrow is a draft lottery. So after the Suns get screwed over again, I'm going to be eating all. Actually, I'm going to be dead. So the Phoenix Suns, they have the best chance at the number one pick. No team in the lottery has a better chance at number one. The worst they can go is four, and the best they can get is one. So one, two, three, or four.
They're gonna get three.
Oh, so
this happens every year.
You know? It does. You're right. It happens every year.
They give it to them. It's on purpose.
If what my dad is saying is true and the Suns get three, I'll probably be dead. Sorry, mom. But
Hey.
Where are you going?
To get something from my merch.
I know, but there's something. Oh, Brian.
Why is it?
This is where it went. I've been looking for it.
I've lost some jackets and then I find them here.
What kind? Brian, we had matching ones.
We got matching ones.
Wait, whose closet is this? Who hides the jackets in here? So, okay, Brian, speaking of the... Wait, two? I have two Suns jackets. Tomorrow's the NBA draft lottery, okay? The Suns have the best chance at the number one pick.
They're not gonna get the bro.
Well, yeah, obviously it's the Suns, but they have the best chance at number one. They could be one, two, three, or they could fall all the way down to four. What do you think is gonna happen? Your honest prediction.
I think you guys are gonna get second.
Okay, second, like, I would live with. Third is where, like, I would be dead. And
who would you get if you got second?
It would be either Ayton or Luka Doncic. One of those two. Luka Doncic isn't even in college. Okay, who would you draft if you were first?
What do you mean? Luka Doncic.
What about second?
Ayton.
Ayton.
Okay.
What's his first name?
DeAndre.
DeAndre Ayton. He's
so what if, lit. Now here's a good question. What if you fell to third, who would you draft?
For Jason Tatum.
He did go three last year.
Really?
Hey, mom. So I'm sure you've heard me talk about it for the past 10 years, but Phoenix Suns, best chance to get number one. No team in the NBA has a better chance to get number one than the Suns. Are they going to get one, two, three, or fall all the way to four?
No, I said three. And it's gonna three? Be three. And
so you want me to die?
Well, I'm saying the truth.
Well, even if you said number one, I would die from happiness. So either way, so give me a hug. It's going to be the last time you see me.
I love you. I'd kill you if you say this.
Mom, you know, like, I don't know if you know this, but this is what I've been having nightmares of. Like, I can't sleep because I have nightmares of this.
Really? You think about it like
hold
this?
On. This guy's named Mark Tatum.
Okay.
Do you know this guy?
No.
So this guy, you don't know him? Well, in case you didn't know, the Suns got the fourth pick 2 years in a row.
Oh, sorry.
So I don't know how I'm alive right now, first of all. Look at his smile. It's like he's happy to give the Suns the fourth pick.
Yeah, I was going to say, does he want?
I literally have nightmares of this guy's face, guys. He's how happy to give the Suns the fourth pick.
Is he going to announce it?
Yeah.
He's going to be even more happy.
For what?
To announce him third or fourth.
Brian, what? Stop. It's not a joke. Bosley, what do you think? Fourth? No. How about first? Yeah, I think Bosley says it's fourth. So are you sure you don't want to change your answer, Mom? Oh, you know the Suns have never, ever, ever got number one pick in history? I swear.
So you want me to say one? Tell me and I'll say it.
Yeah, can you say one?
They're going to get number one.
Yeah!
But tomorrow's the day.
Inshallah. Oh. Bosley said, what do you mean they're getting number one? I said fourth. Great, you got my dad, my mom, Brian. The whole family's here. This might be the last time you ever see me. Bye. Skies, I love you, I swear. You did everything for me. I don't know. Keep laughing, Dad. Yeah, I don't know if it's funny, but bye, Dad. I'll miss you forever, Dad. Mom, I love you so much. Oh, the day after Mother's Day, Brian. My last drive ever. Let's enjoy my final drive. Such a fool! Find a man like you! Please, Suns, get the number one pick! Please, Suns, get the number one pick! We have never had the number one pick! Please let it happen this year! I'm begging you, please, God! Oh! Please, not the fourth pick, please. Or the third, even the third, I'll be sad. Please, God, please. I'm crying, please. Wanna see the Suns get number one. Please let it happen, please. Cause I wanted to. Nobody wants to see the Suns get the number one pick, but let it happen, please, cause I want it to.
Call me on your flight back to you.
I hope you know that I want the Suns to get number one. Cause I know we're gonna get screwed over and we're not gonna get number one, but I want it to happen so bad. But big boys don't cry. Unless the Suns get the third or fourth pick in the draft lottery, then we do cry, we cry, we cry, we cry, we cry, we cry, We need the number one pick. Please give us number one. Can we pretend that the Phoenix Suns are gonna get the number one pick tomorrow? Wish right now. Damn, I didn't even have to change the lyrics for the second part. You said I could really use a wish right now. Yeah, if I had one wish right now, number one pick. Come Phoenix's way, baby. Number one pick, we need it. Okay, I'll go back to my karaoke. I love singing, guys. I may have the worst voice in the world and like nobody likes when I sing and I probably crack mirrors and you know, but I really don't care. I like singing, so I'm gonna keep singing. All the other teams have got the number one pick except the Suns. Please let it happen. Please, please. Bro, I have a good voice. Honestly, I've never like thought about pursuing a singing career. And then none of that rapping shit. Now, I'm not a rapper. I'm not a rapper. I'm a singer. Rappers, you know, they go with flow. They depend on the beat. For me, I just go natural, you know, my voice. No, I'm a singer, not a rapper. Yeah, I've never really thought about pursuing a singing career. But honestly, after today, pumped up kicks, you better run all the other kids with pumped up kicks. No, I'm just joking. I feel bad for all the other artists that, you know, their voice isn't as good as mine. I don't want to just jump into the singing game and, you know, be number one on all the charts. I feel bad. I'm gonna let these other artists have their fun, and then when it's time for me to come in, then I'll take over the singing game. But for now, you know, I'm gonna lay low and I'm gonna let, you know, Cardi B, Drake, Migos, I'm gonna let all these people have their fun for now until I step in the singing game, and then it's adios to those. Possibly the last basketball game I'm watching. By the way, guys, before the series started, I predicted Warriors in five. A lot of people are saying how there's going to be a super close series and how the Rockets and Warriors are going to go back and forth. I'm sorry, I just don't see it happening. Warriors in five. And I think people are really underestimating just how good this Golden State team is. Maybe the best team in NBA history. No offense, Rocket fans. You guys have a really, really good team. I'm actually rooting for Houston to win this series, but they're just matched up against Golden State, they're so good. The Warriors are just, they're way too good. You know what, guys? I'm sitting here, you know, watching Booker eat. Because obviously, like, all basketball fans know that the NBA hates the Phoenix Suns. So tomorrow they're going to fall in the draft lottery. Of course, they're not going to get number one. We all know this. And I just thought about it. You know, I'm really tired. I was about to fall asleep. It's getting really, really late. You know, let me show you guys. It's very dark outside. I just thought about it. I don't want to spend what might be my last night by myself. Like, I don't want to spend it in this little apartment, you know? I want to spend it with family, so I'm going to take a little trip. I got to bring my blankets, pillows, and bring the dog with me because, you know, I'm talking all this, you know, crazy talk, sad, and, you know, all this could go away if the NBA just gives the Suns a number one pick, and, you know, I'm happy. Booker, leave her.
Mom, your hair looks a little nappy there.
Hey, but he kicked her in the... Who's this boy? Brian, if you actually think I'm sleeping in this room alone, like, I hope you, like, you laugh because you're joking because we're both sleeping here.
All
right. I know, but last year we felt the fourth. The year before we felt the fourth. I don't like the number four anymore. That's the thing. I don't want to hear fourth or third. Can you call the NBA office?
I was going to say I'll hit up the guy tomorrow.
Yeah. His name's Mark Tatum. So just...
No, I talked to him. I made them get fourth.
Oh, you did?
You're being mean to me.
Really?
You're being.
Shut up. No, but Brian, please. Just tell him. Tell him any other fans of other teams. Like, yeah, they'll be sad if their team falls, but they won't die. Oh, I'm gonna miss this picture.
Brandon, shut up.
Who knows? Maybe this one's getting number one, Brian.
Get number one.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, guys. It is. Wait, first of all, look at what a traitor I am. Look at my background compared to my dog. But 11:42. It's almost midnight. Brian ditched me. I can't fall asleep because I'm way too nervous. There is 16 and a half hours until the NBA draft lottery. That actually, if you want to be exact, 16 hours and 48 minutes until the NBA draft lottery. And I don't want to go to sleep. I'm scared to go to sleep because I already know once I close my eyes, this is all I'm going to see in my nightmares. I could just hear his voice right now with the fourth pick.
6.5 hours later.
Today is the day. This dumbass woke Booker up and now he's complaining. Why is he so hyper? Why is he so hyper?
Oh my god, his nails.
I know, he has like Freddy Krueger nails. Are you nervous for today? There's 8 hours left. I don't think I should watch it here, like for the safety of our family. Brian. You mind if I take a nap really quick? I couldn't get any sleep last night because I was so nervous.
Yeah, go.
Is it cool?
Yeah, go.
All right, thanks, bro.
Are you like just going to film me sleeping?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah, why not?
Right. Kind of weird, but
Go to sleep.
Okay, sorry. Brian.
What? What the hell?
Where's the envelope with the fourth pick?
What envelope?
I swear I just saw it.
Brandon, you were asleep. What are you talking about? It's only been 10 minutes.
Oh, really?
What the hell, bro?
You sure you didn't hold like a envelope in front of my face?
I swear. I was just standing in the same spot recording you sleep.
I can't fall asleep, I swear.
So yeah, I don't suggest that.
Okay, guys, so we are about 1 hour away from the NBA draft lottery. I don't, like, Brian, like, if there's a puddle, it's not pee from Boston. Like, it's my armpit sweat. But I just want to read you guys a couple of facts before the lottery begins. So, like I mentioned a million times in this video, the Phoenix Suns have the best chance at getting the number one pick out of any team in the NBA. The past 3 years, for 3 years in a row, the team that had the best chance at number one got number one.
Really?
So 3 years in a row, okay? Let me say another thing. 7 years in a row, the team that had the best chance, aka the Phoenix Suns, stayed in the top two, yes.
I knew it.
So ever since 2011, if you had the worst record in the league, aka the Suns, you either picked one or two. 2010 was the last time a team had the worst record and they fell to three or four. So if trends continue, the Suns should have a top two pick. They should. Like I said, I would love the number one pick, but I wouldn't be too mad with number two. I wouldn't be too upset. So number one or number two is fine with me. The Phoenix Suns have never, ever, ever had the number one pick in history. In history. We have been a franchise for 50 years. 5-0. So last year, the Phoenix Suns were actually supposed to have the number two pick, but guess what? They were the only team to fall two spots. So they went from number two to number four. They drafted number four. The year before that, guess where they picked? Number four. They have picked number four 2 years in a row. Brian, stop. You wanna know the last time the Suns moved up in the draft lottery?
When?
1987, Brian.
The NBA was a thing back
Brian, then? Brian, 31 years ago is the last time the Suns moved up in the lottery. I'm not even asking to move up. I just wanna stay put.
I'm scared for you. Like, Brian. I'm actually nervous because you're nervous. How nervous you are.
Think about it. The last time the Suns moved up in the draft lottery, freaking Ronald Reagan was president. Magic Johnson was MVP of the NBA, Brian. Magic Johnson. So, yeah, guys, I guess you could say I'm a little nervous. The Suns are either going to pick number one, two, three, or four. And like I said, the team with the worst record in the league has not fell to three or four over the past 7 years. So please, guys, I'm begging for number one. Number two would be okay also, just not three or four. Please.
It's getting harder for me to breathe. Booker, I can't breathe. Guys, we are 20 minutes away and my heart is tightening more and more with every second that passes. Like, I wish I was joking. Wait, I need water. I haven't drank enough water today and that is not gonna help this cause. Great, no water. Oh, this will do. Actually, this is probably gonna make me go faster. Booker, please, bro, make me feel better. A dog is a man's best friend. You're not supposed to walk away in a time like this. I swear I feel dizzy. No, I feel dizzy. I know, there's 15 minutes left. Maybe it's better if I just don't watch it.
Pale.
Mom, no, I'm not joking. I need to drink water. There was no water in the fridge. I tweeted, it's getting hard for me to breathe. I tweeted that. And I love you guys because you guys are so supportive and you guys are like, OMG, what's wrong? What's happening? Please call 911 if it's hard for you to breathe. It's not that. It's just that I am a Suns fan. I've been a Suns fan my whole life. And us Suns fans know what happens during these NBA draft lotteries. So, like, I just know we're going to get screwed.
Don't think like this. Think positive.
Like, how am I supposed to think positive when last year we fell to number 4? And the year before that, we fell to number 4. 2 years in a row. No. Hold on. There's 2 minutes left. Remember when I broke my arm and I almost passed out at the doctor's? I feel the same way. I swear I feel the same way. Pre-lottery positions, Phoenix number 1. Like I said, the best chance at getting the number 1 pick. That's my wing, Luka Doncic. I want him on the Sun. I want him or DeAndre Ayton. One of those will do. That's why even if we get number 2, I wouldn't mind. You motherfucker, we don't care about the damn... Just pull the envelopes out. Just pull the envelopes out and make the pick. It's 5 o'clock. The show started at 4:30. It's been 30 minutes and they haven't even made me show an envelope. Booker, I'm sorry. This is just one of the most important days in Phoenix Suns history. Okay, guys, the draft lottery is about to start. If you're wondering why I'm watching it over here and not at my apartment, it's because I don't want to get kicked out of my apartment. Like, there was a high chance if I watch this at my apartment, the landlord would call and I'd get kicked out. So I'm watching it here where there's a lot of open land.
Yeah! Woo! I can't be loud because... Booker's about to fall asleep. Oh, I feel bad for him in a couple minutes, actually.
I'm gonna throw up, I swear. Oh, it's not the guy in my nightmares that's making the picks. I was looking forward to seeing him, damn it. You showed it a million times. 2 million times, actually, you showed it. No, like, I don't think it's a joke anymore. If the Suns end up picking 3 or 4, I don't think I'm gonna watch basketball anymore. It's not a joke at this point. No, he's back. He's back. Should I just turn the TV off? We don't have to watch. That's my apology for what's gonna happen. No. Please, hold on. Let me just say one thing. This is too much commercial. Like, now I know how you guys feel with my ads. Now I know what you guys complain about in the comment section. It's times like this, I swear. I'm gonna pee my pants, I swear it's not a joke. No. The fourth pick. No, this can't be real. Oh. Oh. Holy shit. So the Suns are not 4th. That's 1 strike down. The Suns are not 4th. My legs are shaking. I can't stand straight. So, okay, the good news is the Suns are not 4th. The bad news is they could still be 3rd. How did 2 teams jump into the top 3? So, right, we really didn't get the 4th pick? Okay, so we didn't get number 4. Hey, Booker. Oh my God. Please not number 3. Please not number 3. We get number 2, I'm not complaining. I'll cry a little bit, but I would not complain. Number 1, I would cry tears of joy. Number 3, how hard is it? I'm probably jumping. How high is it? Yeah, it's... I'm dizzy. I'm about to pass out, I swear. So now we just have to avoid number 3. So after the commercial break, they're going to open the envelope, and that's going to be pick number 3. Please don't let it be the Suns. Hey, LeBron. Not the Suns. Yes! We got number one! What the fuck? We got number one! Booker! Come here! What the fuck? Oh, the boss is here. They haven't met yet. Hold on. Mom! Oh my God! God! Thank you, God! Where'd they go?
to the dinner.
Oh, they're not here? Booker, guys! Oh, I'm about to break my other hand, I swear. This one's already broken. Guys, the Phoenix Suns are picking number one. We're picking number one. It's over. Devin Booker. Hey, buddy. Hey, you want to bite me? Go ahead. Devin Booker, Josh Jackson, the number one pick. I didn't even want. Guys. I love the NBA. I fucking love basketball. I love basketball so much. Listen, guys. I love you guys so, so much. I love you guys so much. I love the Suns. I love my dog. I love Bosley. My family. God. I couldn't have done it without any of you guys. I swear. I could not have done it without you. This is... The Suns are going to be good again. Yes. All those losses. Hey, Suns fans. When I was watching all the games this season and I was begging for the Suns to lose and you guys were tweeting me saying you're not a true fan, why do you want the Suns to lose? This is why! This is why! Guys, I'm gonna close this video out. I can't, I have too many emotions right now. I can't. Guys, that's gonna close today's video. Bosley, come here, come here. I know usually I ask for a kiss, but today I'm asking for a makeout. Guys, holy shit, yes! You want to come to Phoenix, DeAndre, or you want Luka Doncic? I don't care. Either one works for me. I'm out, guys. I'm out. Peace. Yeah, I can never ever find the right words. And there's no way this is real life. There's no telling you're the right girl. So I can only say that it feels right.